Hey everybody, Jonathan Folsom here, technical agronomist with Winfield United. Today we're going to talk about sugarcane aphids and sorghum. So I've seen sugarcane aphids across most of the Texas Panhandle this year, and today is August the 4th, and so we can expect that based on the large amount of grain sorghum acres here in West Texas, that sugarcane aphids are just going to continue to rapidly increase and explode and get worse. So we haven't seen them quite as bad over the last 4 years, really, and I think that's really because there has not been a whole lot of grain sorghum quite to the extent that there is this year. So lots of grain sorghum, lots of opportunities for aphids and sugarcane aphids to become a problem. So let's talk about a couple of different aphid species, what to do about sugarcane aphids, and kind of how to monitor them. So if you look in the top, you're finding these aphids in the top of the plant and these dark green ones like this in the whorl. Well, you're not going to worry about those. Those are called corn leaf aphids. And really, I like to think of them in a beneficial way because they're a good food source for these ladybug larvae and other beneficials that are in here feeding on those aphids. And corn leaf aphids will be up in the whorl. Sugarcane aphids will be on the bottom, the undersides of a leaf. So there's a few right there. There's a few here. Oh, look right here. We've got basically what I'd say is an established colony of sugarcane aphids. So there may be about 50 aphids there. That's the threshold for saying it's an established colony. There may not quite be 50 there, but I'd say if it's quarter sized, then you've probably got about 50 aphids in there. So here's a good example of an established colony. So how do you know when to treat for sugarcane aphids? Well, let's say when you check your field, out of 10 plants, if 3 plants have an established colony of aphids, then you should consider treatment. Now, that's assuming that you're scouting and that you're not just checking the edge of the field. I think, personally, I've seen the sugarcane aphids show up on the edge of the field before they will in the middle. You know, especially so if you're trying to find them and you haven't found them yet and you really need to find some, go start looking on the south edge of those fields, looking for some bigger plants that those winged aphids are going to fly onto, and then go down and look in those bottom leaves. That's where you'll probably find them to start off with. And then you can start checking through the field. So, you know, if you haven't found them in your field, then just checking once a week is fine. Once you find them, you need to move that threshold, that scouting interval, to twice a week. And the reason for that is that these aphids can go from, you know, a established colony of this size one day to 2 days later, they're covering 2 leaves. So just the way they just explode. And of course, aphids reproduce asexually. They're all females and they're all born pregnant. So things happen in a hurry, really fast. So there's some good insecticide options out there. But regardless of which insecticide you use, there's one really important thing that you need to do, and that is you need to add the adjuvant PowerLock. Now, PowerLock is going to be really, really beneficial by adding the depth of coverage. We get that from the interlock that's in PowerLock. So it gives you canopy penetration, depth of coverage through that canopy down to these lower leaves where those sugarcane aphids are going to be at. And it's also got a non-ionic surfactant like preference in there that's going to give you that spreading opportunity so when that insecticide gets on the leaf, then it's going to do its job. So remember, no matter what pesticide you use for sugarcane aphids, make sure that you use PowerLock by Winfield United for the best results that you can get. For Winfield United, I'm Jonathan Folsom. Thanks for watching and thank you for your business.